Hello, I'm Robin Worley, welcome to LensCraft. Today I'm making an initial review of On1 NoNoise AI. If you aren't aware of the software, it's a new noise reduction offering from On1, who also developed the excellent On1 Photo RAW software. Applying AI to problems like sharpening and noise reduction has caught on in the past couple of years, and it feels like On1 are a little bit late to the game. It's going to be interesting to see how usable their software is, as well as how well it performs. Currently, I'm using Topaz Denoise as my go-to software of choice for noise reduction, and it performs very well in most situations. But this video isn't about making a direct comparison, although I will share a couple of these. Instead, I want to look at On1 NoNoise to see how well it performs from a usability perspective. Is it easy to use? How well does it remove noise? And are there any problems that I'm seeing? Let's start by launching On1 NoNoise as a standalone editor. The advantage of this is that you can edit RAW files directly, which apparently is when the software performs best. You can also use the software as a plugin for the likes of Photoshop. Whilst there are benefits to this, the drawback is that you're processing data that's already been processed, so the noise reduction isn't as good. I'll look at an example of this later in the video. When you first launch NoNoise AI as a standalone editor, you initially see an empty screen. You can then either open photos using the dialog, or you can drag and drop them onto the interface. I've already sorted out a few RAW files with quite nasty noise to see how the software performs. The first one we'll look at was shot handheld with a Panasonic Lumix LX5 pocket camera back in 2011. The camera was set to ISO 400, but it has a tiny sensor that really struggles with low light. If I zoom to 200% magnification, you can see there's a lot of noise, particularly in the sky. But when I turn on the noise reduction preview, you can see a big improvement. It's also possible to have the preview in split screen mode, which makes the improvement more obvious. But the other thing that I want you to notice is how much clearer the image is. Initially, I thought this was down to the sharpening settings, but it isn't. I can set the sharpening sliders to zero, and the image is still much crisper. Look at the detail in the aerials on the tower. In fact, let's zoom into this area at 400% because I want to show you how clean and sharp the results are. The detail the software is producing is nothing short of spectacular. So far, I'm just using the default settings, although I have turned off the sharpening. Looking at the tower, you can see there are some artifacts around the fine detail in the aerials, but watch what happens when I reduce the enhanced detail slider. Although the image doesn't look quite as sharp, it's now extremely clean. Now let's look at another example with even more severe noise. This is another LX5 example that I shot handheld well after sunset. The ISO was set at 3200 and I shot this specifically for testing noise reduction software. With the noise preview turned off, you can see how bad the noise is at 100% magnification. When I turn on the NoNoise processing, it's instantly cleaned up. What's surprising me most about this image though is not only how NoNoise removed the noise, but how much detail is retained in the distance. With traditional non-AI noise reduction, the detail seems to be destroyed by the processing. To show you what I mean, here's a section of the image at 200% magnification after processing with Nick Define. This was the best I could achieve after a lot of adjustment. Define just can't cope with the level of noise in this image. But with NoNoise, you can see much more detail in the sand and the noise has gone. I just want to show you one final example though before looking at some comparisons. This time it's a handheld snap taken with a Panasonic GX1 Micro Four 3 camera at ISO 800. As before, you can see lots of noise when magnified to 100%. If I increase the magnification to 200%, you can see that the image is soft in the foreground. But when processed with the NoNoise auto settings, it seems to snap into focus and the noise is removed from the sky. Having tested On1 NoNoise on quite a few RAW files, I'm extremely impressed by the results. It appears to be exceptionally quick at processing the raw files, and I've only spotted a few minor problems in the results. What I would say though is that you shouldn't just rely on the auto settings. I seem to get my best results when I turn off the sharpening and check for the best enhanced detail setting at 200% magnification. Whilst I'm not covering it in this video, it's also worth pointing out that On1 NoNoise supports layers and masking. This means you can build up an image applying different settings to different areas for excellent results. I'll look at this in another video because there's so much you can do. Now let's look at a couple of comparisons in a little more depth. The first comparison that I want to share is made by applying the noise reduction directly to the raw files. I've then combined the images as layers in the single Photoshop image to make the comparison easier. The first layer is the raw conversion made in Photoshop without any sharpening or noise reduction. Whilst I haven't made any adjustments in Photoshop, Photoshop has applied lens corrections. You can see the difference this makes when I turn on the no-noise layer, which doesn't have any optical correction. Let's zoom now to 200% magnification to check the results. You can see plenty of noise in the original, but that's been very effectively removed in the no-noise layer. But what did surprise me a little was that the no-noise image wasn't sharper in comparison. I didn't sharpen the original RAW file, but when I was doing the conversion, no-noise looked sharper, but in the output file, it doesn't look any sharper. Because of this, I decided to run the image through Topaz Sharpen AI, which did seem to improve it a little. Finally, here's the Topaz denoise version using the low light noise reduction. I tried all the settings in Topaz, and low light noise was the best, with clear AI mode being a close second. Comparing the On1 NoNoise results, I can see Topaz denoise has applied lens correction and reduced the contrast. But when it comes to noise reduction performance, On1 NoNoise looks to have edged it. If we check the tower again at 400%, you can see some noise artifacts in the Topaz version. Now compare that with On1 NoNoise and the results are better, especially when combined with Topaz Sharpen AI. Now let's look at the second sample RAW file which has severe colour and luminance noise. As before, I've converted the RAW file using Photoshop with the noise reduction and sharpening turned off. I've then copied the image and processed that rather than the RAW file to produce the different layers. This should be a more demanding test of the software as it doesn't have the RAW data to work with. If I zoom the image to 100%, this is the best I could achieve using NicDefine. Now this isn't to criticise NicDefine in any way, as it works well with less severe examples of noise. Unfortunately, it can't clean up this image, leaving noise and creating artifacts. When I turn on Topaz denoise, you can see how much better the processing is. When we compare this with On1 NoNoise, you can't see much difference between the two. But if we zoom to 200% and look just behind the post, you can see that it has a little more detail retained in the sand. I'm sure you'll agree that the results are impressive when you consider this was a pocket camera with a tiny sensor at 3200 ISO in low light conditions. Out of interest, I also processed the RAW file directly in On1 NoNoise to see if it's any better. Whilst there isn't any optical correction, you can see that it's retained much more detail. It appears the On1 recommendation to process the RAW file rather than a TIFF or JPEG is a good one. Before we leave this example, there is a problem I've noticed when using On1 NoNoise. You can see it best along the edges of the sand. There are a few pixels around the edge of the image frame that the software doesn't seem to clean up. You can also see the same problem when processing the RAW file directly. You may need to crop this out, although at 100% magnification, it isn't very noticeable. Now to the final comparison, which is more of a test than a comparison. This time I processed the RAW file using On1 NoNoise, but then I continued to process the image in Photoshop until it was finished. Often when applying strong adjustments, any noise left in the image can become obvious. My adjustments were made first in Nik Color Effects Pro to enhance the dynamic contrast. After that, I used Nik Viveza to enhance the colour and regular contrast. Then I dodged the sky and the hills to lighten them slightly. After that, I made a frequency separation to enhance the sky. Finally, I added a soft dark vignette around the edge of the image. Looking at the image at 100% magnification, it looks clean and I don't see any noise. Ordinarily, with adjustments like this, you would risk noise showing up, but this image is noise-free and very usable. Overall, I'm extremely impressed by the results when using On1 NoNoise. The auto adjustments are good, but you can improve on them with a little care. There isn't much in the way of control over the noise reduction, but then that's the whole idea of applying AI to noise reduction. Where things do become a little bit more complicated is if you want to use the layers and masks, which I'm going to cover in another video. Overall, performance seems to be quick and the results are super clean. The only real problem seems to be the few pixels around the edge of the frame that seem to be left, but that's easy enough to fix. Whether this is the best software for you will depend on your needs and expectations. I would though recommend downloading and testing the trial version before deciding to make a purchase. And if you do decide to make a purchase, I do have a 15% discount code which I'll share in the YouTube video information. I hope that you've enjoyed this review. If you have, please take a moment to share it with others. I'm Robin Worley, you've been watching LensCraft. I'll see you soon for another video.